Hey, what's up, guys? If you have forgotten your password and need to gain access to the locked out account on your system, then stick around. In this video, I will show you how to reset your local password for Windows 11 or Windows 10 PC without losing your data or without using any third-party software. My name is Mazhar, and at Right Solution, I create tutorial for all you DIY people. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. Now, without any further ado, let's get to this video. This is my Windows temporary setup for this video only. So let's go ahead and try entering the password here. I'll just enter some wrong password. So as it says, it's a wrong password. Let's try once more. And you can say it says wrong password. So click OK on here. And you can see this option here for reset password. So after clicking this reset password, Windows 11 gives you options to set up some security questions in case that you forget your PIN or your password. So I have set up for this Windows installation the security password. So let's go and enter the answers of these three questions, which if you had entered, you should remember that. And after entering, first let's go to the second one, and you can see I'm entering the second one, and then you also have to answer the answer number question number three, also write the correct answers. And after entering all this, click on this arrow to submit this answers, and now it will prompt you to create a new password. So just create a password if you want to. So just let's go and add a new password here. And you can also say confirm password. So just repeat it once more and then click to the arrow, and here you are. So you are already in your system if you had set up your security questions and you remember them. So entering that will allow you to get into the system. So that is the first solution for you. I hope you have that set up. And now if you did not, so let's go and see how we reset actually the password. So come again onto the Windows screen where you are stuck. So next to the power button, if you see, there is a icon which says accessibility. If you click on it, so you see there's a lot of features which allows you to do a lot of stuff to improve your vision or just see it bigger. So we will actually convert the program attached to this accessibility icon to command prompt shortcut. And actually this changing a password is in three phases. So first one, we will convert that icon into a command prompt. For that, we will rename some files. So the first file which we are going to rename will be that utilman.exe. We will rename into utilman.exe. You can say exe1, or maybe max. I'll just put max because I remember this. I mostly use this one. And then we will use the second file, which is actually command.exe. So we will rename that to utilman.exe. So when we will click that button, so it will bring the command prompt. So that is the first part where we convert it. And then the second part will be where we will reset the password. And the third part, then we will revert that, what we the change what we just did. So now we know the game plan. So let's go and convert this icon to the command prompt. Press the shift key on your keyboard and come to the power button here and click on restart and restart again anyway, and then wait till this blue screen comes up. So keep your shift key pressed and wait, wait a little more. And here now you can release the shift key, and now come to this troubleshoot menu here. Just click on this one, and on this page here, so click on advanced options. And now in this page, click on command prompt. Now here, change the drive from X to C. So just type C colon and hit enter. And now type CD, change directory to Windows. So just CD Windows and enter, okay. So we got a message here. The system cannot find the path specified. So let's see what is in the drive C. So just type DIR, so to list the directories. And now it says volume in drive C is system reserved. So if you have multiple system installed, so possibly your Windows directory is installed on another drive. So let's go and look for drive D. So say D colon and hit enter. Now type DIR again to see if your Windows directory is here. And you can see that Windows directory exists in this drive D. So now just type CD Windows to just come into the Windows directory. So now again from here, type CD system32 to come into the system32 directory. So now let's go and rename the file. So type here REN, which is stands for rename, utilman.exe2, give a space, and then type utilman.exe max and enter.
And now let's do the other one. So just type here again, rename cmd.exe space, and just write down utilman.exe and enter. And now exit, we are done here. So just say exit and it will close. And now just continue to these windows. And now you can see that if you click on this icon, so it will bring you up the command prompt. So let's click on it. And now here, just type control user passwords 2 and enter. And now this is the place where you can actually reset the password. And remember that this is the local user account, so you can reset password for the local users. But if you have an account which is connected to your computer from the Microsoft account, so for that, the reset option will be grayed out, so you cannot click on that one. For that, you really need to go and change your password by logging into the Microsoft account. So I have another video where I have given some hints. I'll put the link to that video in my description of this video. So now for this video, you can just go and click on the reset here. So just type the password if you want, but I'll leave the blank. So just click it on OK and then OK again. And now here you can just see that our work is done with this dialog box here. So you can just type exit here. So the dialog box will close, and now you are back into the to the Windows login page. So just click on this arrow and it will let you enter because you did not set up any password. And now if you want to set up a password again, so let's do it again. Just come to this Windows icon here and right click on it. And look for settings. Let's maximize it. And now from here, from the left side, click on accounts. And in accounts here, just go down a little bit and click on sign in options. And now from here, just click on passwords. Just click that tab. And now you can see that use a password to sign in to Windows. So just click on add, and you can type in the password whatever you want to. So just let's try typing something here and reconfirm that password again. And you can give also a hint. So I'll just say my old password and just click on next. And here you can see that your local account is already having a password. So just click on finish. So you can just close this one. And now if you want to check it, so just click on this Windows button again and go to the power, and you can restart. But let's go and I think click on sleep. It do the same thing. Maybe it will click on sleep here. And now you can just type in the password again. So click on this arrow back. And here you can see that we are already into the system. But we are not done yet, so we have to just revert the changes what we did in the beginning. So for that, let's go back to this screen on the login screen. So press down the shift key on your keyboard and press the power button and just restart anyway. And now wait, keep your shift key down and wait till this blue screen comes up again. And now you can release the shift key and on this click troubleshoot. On this page, advanced options, and click on command prompt. And if you remember that my Windows directory is on D, so type D colon, and now here again CD Windows, and again CD system 32. And now here we will just type the commands again, rename utilman.exe to cmd.exe, enter. And now do the second one here. So we will type again, rename utilman.exe max space utilman.exe. Enter. And we are done here. So just type exit. And now you can just continue to Windows again. We are in the login screen. Let's go and see if this accessibility button had got back the functionality. So just click on it. Here we are. You can see all this menu which we had seen in the beginning. So it is back. So let's go and type the password and see if everything is working now. So just type in password and click on the arrow. And here we are. So we are back into the regular Windows system.
So that's it for this video, guys. If you think this video added some value or given you some help, so please give it a thumbs up. And I will see you with the next video. You have a wonderful day.